गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, इन ग्रेड 9 साइंस कंप्राइजेस ऑफ 3 बाइफर्केशंस रादर देन क्लासिफिकेशंस, फिजिक्स, केमिस्ट्री एंड बायोलॉजी। सो टुडे वी विल बी स्टार्टिंग विथ फिजिक्स। फिजिक्स इज हैविंग लेसन्स एज मोशन, लॉज ऑफ मोशन, ग्रेविटेशन, वर्क एंड एनर्जी एंड साउंड। My dear students, I am not underestimating you. I am not scaring you. But in grade 9, physics is mathematics only. It means in grade 9, you are having two mathematics. One mathematics itself and other is physics. Because in physics, you all are having the only matter said numericals. So let us start with the first topic, motion. Now the topic motion, the word motion, you can imagine birds are flying. You can imagine the fish swims underwater. Cars, bikes, vehicles are moving on the road. If we talk about planets, planets rotate and revolve around the sun. These all examples are of motion. So the word motion, you understood that any object which is not at rest position, that means it is in motion. So now there are various types of motion. The first one, motion along the straight line. In this category, it can be more specifically bifurcated as one more type called as rectilinear motion also. Motion along the straight line, the word and the concept is very clear. It is along the straight line. But rectilinear motion is, it is absolutely straight line without any curves. Second type is circular motion. Another type you can go with, rotational motion, circular motion, vibratory motion. There are various types of motion we can talk about. But in this topic, we will be talking first of all motion along the straight line. For this, just an example. If this is A to B, this is the rest position, we can call it as origin also. It means from where we originate. For example, object or a person starting from this as a origin travels the entire distance, maybe 100 kilometers. Then he comes back till the point C. Okay, so he went like this till here 100 kilometers and then he came back maybe 30 kilometers. Okay, so now I am going to define some definitions. The first definition here is distance. So what is distance? Distance is the actual path covered by an object. This is object, person, who travels the distance from A to B. From A to B, he has traveled 100 kilometers. Okay. Then he came back along the same path till C, that is 30 kilometers. It means the question asked to you, how much distance is traveled by the object? So simply you can say that the object has traveled 130 kilometers. Got the point? It means distance is the actual path covered by an object. Okay. Now, if we consider here the object travels from A to B and then B to C, it means the object's journey has ended here at this point. And the object has initiated the journey from here. It means the starting point is A and the ending point is C. So another definition is coming, that is displacement. So how we can define displacement? Displacement means it is the shortest distance covered between the initial and the final position. Okay, here you can see the object started the journey from A, went till B and came back till C. Here the journey was ended. So now displacement means the distance in between the initial and the final point. Here the initial point is A and the final point is C. So now you can tell or you can guess that what will be the displacement covered by this object. See here, this entire distance is of 100 km and 30 is being minused. So what is the displacement? Displacement here is 70 km. So you understood two definitions. The first definition is distance. Distance is the actual path covered by an object, and displacement means the shortest distance in between initial and final position. After talking about distance and displacement, now here are very basic three formulas which will be used not only in this lesson motion but in laws of motion, then gravitation, then work and energy, and till sound. That's why these basic formulas are very important. As you know about distance is the actual path covered, displacement is the shortest distance in between initial and final position. So now let us talk about speed. Speed is equal to distance upon time. It means the distance covered per unit time is called as speed. If we come on velocity, then velocity is displacement upon time. The major difference in between speed and velocity is simply the direction. This is the major difference in between these two. Speed is without direction, but velocity is with direction. So the term which you have learned in 8th standard, that is scalar and vector, such type of question also can be framed that speed is a scalar quantity because it is having only magnitude, that means value, but velocity is a vector quantity because it has magnitude as well direction. So speed and velocity, if we come on the variables which are denoted to speed and velocity, speed is told to us by V, and that is distance upon time. Distance is given by S and T, time, and the unit for that is meter per second. As you know that there are two types of unit, MKS unit and CGS unit, and CGS unit and MKS unit, out of these two, one unit is being chosen internationally, that is called as International Standard Unit, that is SI unit. So finally we all have to follow SI units, so we are writing meter per second. If you see velocity, the formula is same, only I have put here vector on V. After putting a vector, speed becomes velocity, and after putting a vector here, distance becomes displacement. While writing the formulas in normal practice, we don't have to use these vectors. Okay, that is considered. So here the formula is same, meter per second. Now if we come on the third and important thing, that is acceleration. Acceleration is rate of change of velocity. Rate of change of velocity. Rate means here, rate means time. And change of velocity. Change of velocity is, there are two types of velocities. So first velocity is u, that is called as initial velocity. And the another velocity is v, that is called as final velocity. So change in velocity, that means final minus initial, you can see here acceleration is v minus u upon t, and the unit is meter per second square. So these are three important formulas which we have discussed. Rest of the things or then another topic I am putting in the next video.